hungry, but my relationship makes me hungry. Getting off the phone early don't make you holy.
That's right.
But if you holy, you get off the phone. In tongues. I speak in tongues because I am holy. I don't speak in tongues to be holy. I don't make any sense. Who taught you that you have to try to be something that God said he is making you into? By my hands, behold, I will do a new thing. Can you perceive it? Can you perceive it? We started this year with a new you. But the reason you didn't get to a new you is because you never perceived what God was doing in your life. He said you got to be able to perceive it. You can't have it until you perceive it. You won't receive it until you perceive it. God was doing something new in my life. God is doing something new in my life. And I will change my behaviors so that he can do something new. I change my behaviors because he's done something. I know it's a small distinction, but it's a distinction.
That is so good.
The final word, and this is, Jesus, Lord. Now, this is it. He said, by all this, show yourself an example.
Right.
Show yourself an example.
Right.
Show yourself an example.
Yes.
Show yourself an example.
Yes, sir.
Show yourself an example. Be an example. Be an example. Be an example. And so I was thinking about how that, what did that mean? Because sometimes you got to go a little deeper. Amen. You got to go out. Remember that on the boat. You got to go out a little bit deeper. So I went a little deeper. I started to look up the Greek of what that meant, to make yourself an example. And I found a word. It's tupos.
Come on, sir.
And I read deep into that word.
Yes.
And that word literally means this. To make a mark.
Yes. Yes.
To make a mark. Paul said, do all this to make a mark. They do all this to make a mark. Not some people, nigga. It doesn't matter what people think about you. To make a mark. How you speak, how you act, to make a mark. How you live in faith, to make a mark. Do all this to make a mark. How you conduct yourself, to make a mark. How your purity level, your faith level is all so that you can make a mark. Now that took me back to something you said a long time ago about sin. And sin, the word sin is literally an archery term.
Right.
Sin, the word sin that we use, you know what your grandma told you, stop sinning. It's a word relative to archery.
Yes.
And it literally means this. To sin means to miss the target. It means to miss the mark. Sin means to miss the mark. See, that's why God wants to remove the sin from your life so that you can hit. Everything you're going through, everything you've been through, is so that you can hit the mark. That is a target. That is a place that God said, and if you can get your aim right, if you can get your aim right, if you can put your hand, oh, thank you, Jesus, on the bottle which represents the Holy Spirit, if you can get your hands right on the bottle, and you can pull back with all your might, God said, and then release that arrow. And what I need for you to do, it's just not miss the mark.
Yeah.
Make your mark. Make your mark.
Come on.
Thank you, Lord.
I said, God, that's so good.
Yes, it is.
I said, I'm not done.
Amen.
He said, you're forgetting something that you started with 3 years ago on April 6th.
Yeah.
2014.
Yeah.
He said you started with a single verse. And forgetting those things which are behind me, I press toward.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. I press toward.
Press.
I press toward the mark. mark? Where's your mark? Where's your mark, God Jesus? It's time for you to make your mark. We're a small church, but we carry a big shadow. I need you guys to know that. Because me and my wife, we don't do nothing halfway. We only know how to go. We have two gears, stop and go. There's no one, two, three, there's no Prindle. Get Prindle, park, reverse, neutral drive, low. It's only stop and go. We were determined to make a mark. All you guys, you're our mark.
Yes, they are. Yes.
It is our speech. It is our conduct. It is our faith. It is our purity. You are the result. You are the result. This church, this building is the result. And God called us to make a mark. And we press. We press. We press. Just so you can make your mark. And we'll help you, and we'll pray for you, and we'll push you, and we'll get you there. You gotta make a mark. Stop just living. Live abundantly.
Make
your mark. I know it happened to you. Forgetting those things which are behind you. If you can just press toward the mark of the high calling, which is in Christ Jesus. And you're not alone. You're not alone. As long as you're trying, as long as you're making an effort, I promise you I'll be here. As long as you're giving God all your praise, all the honor, and all the glory, I'll be here with you. I don't care what it is. I don't care what you've been through. I don't care what you did in the past. It doesn't matter. Forgetting those things which are behind you. I don't care if you've been raped or molested or whatever. I don't care. God said there's something. There's something. And I need you to get to it. And I'm calling you to me. And my job is not to wear fancy suits. My job is not to stand on stages with a bunch of lights. My job as your pastor is to help you make your mark. Let me help you. Let me help you make your mark. Let me help you. I'll help you. I promise. Make your mark, man. Make your mark. If you don't know Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, we're going to say a prayer. But I'm going to say it together so nobody feels alone. But if you don't know Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, listen, I believe that if you say this prayer, it's easy to be a Christian. It's ABC, accept, believe, and confess. ABC, accept him, believe in him, and confess him to others. That's all. That's it. That's it. We're going to say this prayer, and we're all going to say it together. But if you say this prayer, I believe that God will come into your heart and that he'll start to point you toward your mark. If you don't know Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, repeat this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, please forgive me for all my sins. Come into my life. Change my life. Come into my mind. Change my mind. Father, I accept you as my Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Now with every head bowed and every eye still closed, I'm going to count to three. And when I get to three, if you said that prayer for the first time or you meant it for the first time, I want you to raise your hand. One, it doesn't matter who you came here with. It doesn't matter who's sitting next to you, who drove you here. Only thing that that matters is your relationship with God. Two, God wants to take you to a new level. He wants to take you to a new place. He says, I know you missed the mark. I know you missed the mark, but I'm there with you. I'm there to pick it all back up and start over again. So this is the moment. This is the moment. If you said that prayer for the first time and you accepted Jesus into your heart, three, raise your hand as high as you can. Somebody's trying to pray with you.
Because they're the best. No, I'm just kidding. You can download